Hello, everyone. All of you are welcome to the present video lecture series in chemistry. And that is today we discuss about the different elements which are present in group number 13. All of you well known, we have to see the periodic table. In periodic table, different periods are arranged. And the group numbers are arranged from the 1 to 18. And in this particular modern periodic table, 13 group is the group of boron family. So that is because in this case, the boron is the main element of this family. Boron itself, which is one of the P block elements, and therefore here first of all the P electrons are there. So the electronic configuration of the boron family that corresponds with the NP1. So that is the N is equal to the outer shell. Here we can see that electronic configuration of boron itself is 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. 5 electrons are there in boron. Boron having 2p1 electron and 2s2 electron. So therefore 3 electrons are there in their outer shell. According to quantum, different quantum numbers, where every electrons having the one of the quantum number differs. Here we can say in boron the first shell contains 2 electrons, whereas the second shell contains the 2 electrons in S subcell and 1 electron in P subcell. So therefore 3 electrons are there in outer shell. Now the valence electrons are only of 3, because outer shell electrons and this can combine with 3 another monovalent atom. For example, boron combined with monovalent elements such as hydrogen, so therefore this will be formed the BH3. BH3 boron hydride. Similarly, boron can react form compounds, and those are the BF3. So BF3 also one of the compound. But here one more thing is there. We have to follow the octet rule. So those octet rules are not followed by this boron. Why? Because in case of the boron, 3 electrons of boron can shared with the 3 electrons of chlorine. So therefore in case of the boron fluoride that have the only 6 electrons in outer shell, so therefore this cannot follow the octet rule regarding. So boron are also electron deficient compounds are present in case of the boron. So one of the aspects regarding this and different atomic properties, like that the first of all the boron atomic size, then boron atomic radii, then we have the boron electron affinity, boron electron negativity, as well as the boron ionization potential, whatever there is. And then one more thing is there, and that is the denoted pair effect. So how this can be seen in this particular presentation? Here the S block elements and P block elements and D block elements, which are separately presented in my video lecture. So all of you have to see my different video lectures, those related with the S block elements as well as P block elements. Here P block elements are further divided into the boron family. So boron, carbon, like that, oxygen, then we have also the inert gases. So in this is the boron family. So group 13 boron family, here different elements are there. The boron, this is the first element, in this one, boron present in the first element. So therefore, boron contains, the atomic number is 5, and here other properties such as the weight and atomic weight, and atomic weights are in fraction. So then after we can see the aluminium, the atomic number is 13. Then the Ga is stands for the gallium, and then indium is the 49, thallium atomic number 81. In this particular series group, suppose we have to see the thallium. So thallium itself is one of the that element is the toxic. So now atomic weight corresponds from 10.8 in boron, 26.98 in aluminium, as well as the gallium having the 69.7, and followed by thallium. So thallium having the atomic weight 204. Now the melting point of these, and this can also seen, but that is the variation in melting point, and electrode potential that also varied, and that depends on what were the changes in the periods. So different electrode potentials are there. In case of the thallium, this is the plus 0.72, as well as the ionization energy that is represented in kilojoule, and this is almost in case of the boron, this is 800, and whereas in other cases in the range of the 500-600. Now boron is the only group 13 family that is a non-metal. Whatever, if suppose we have to distinguish that which one is the melting, so here we can say others are the metal, or the metallic properties, the aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium, these are the metals, whereas this one is the non-metal. Boron itself is the only group 13 element that is a non-metal. The remaining members of the group are fairly reactive metals, and because of that particular characteristics, other are the reactive metals and are called p-block elements. Whatever p-block, it means where the electrons are filled in the p atomic orbitals. So all of you are well known about that. In case of the quantum number, when we see the quantum number of the electrons as well as the electronic configuration, so during the electronic configuration, whatever that is the Hubbard principle, so the last electron goes to p atomic orbitals. So those elements themselves called the p block. That is the blocking. Block means whatever the p subshell. So subshell itself we have to see according to the quantum number. Different quantum numbers activates, and one first quantum number is the principal quantum number, the second is the azimuthal quantum number, and third one magnetic quantum number. So here we can say that different quantum numbers and the azimuthal quantum number showing the subshell. So therefore, in case of the S subshell, that will be the S and azimuthal quantum number itself clearly indicates that S subshell having 0, and then we have the P subshell, that is the 1. So therefore, the whole periodic table itself is arranged in the respective S block as well as the P block, and inside both, that is the transition metal, those are the d-block elements. So boron family itself, from top to down, the starting from the boron to thallium. So out of these, whatever we have, the boron itself is non-metal, whereas the remainings are the metals. These metals are also reactive in reactive metals, because when we have to say from top to down, so therefore the electron which are outer shell can go easily. So in case of the gallium, in the that is also reactive, and they form easily with the different compounds. So here in case of the boron family, you can see that the remaining members are the P block element. Aluminium is the third most abundant element in the earth crust. One more addition in this particular case, that aluminium is present in soil, and that is the clay. So in case of the clay, we have the aluminium oxide. So silicon oxide and aluminium oxide, those are the clay itself. So therefore aluminium is the third most stable compound that is present stable on in the earth crust. So aluminium is the third most abundant element in the earth crust, and whatever all elements show stable oxidation state of 3, except the thallium. Here plus 3 oxidation state is exhibited by group number 13. Whatever the plus 3, so aluminium and gallium, we have to see that after giving the 3 electrons, and from the outer shell, whatever we have, the general electronic configuration in which we already see that there in outer shell, 2 electrons in S subshell and 1 electron in the P subshell. So therefore, they can easily lose those particular 3 electrons. So whatever we can say that their general configuration of group 13 boron family is NS2 and NP1. So therefore 3 electrons in outer shell. So if these 3 electrons removed easily to get the octet configuration of N-1 sub shell. So therefore aluminium plus 3 oxidation state, as well as in case of the gallium, so gallium plus 3. So generally these elements having the plus 3, so this can be seen by the electronic configuration. Here boron, that is the chemical symbol is boron, B, electronic configuration, helium 2s2 2p1, helium itself is inert gas configuration. Then we have the neon in case of the aluminium. So we can say here then the gallium is also one of the important element, and as well as reactive metal. Then we have the indium, and in case of the thallium, whereas in case of the thallium we have the electronic configuration, the xenon itself, this is the whatever we have to say, the complete outer shell there is with the octet 8 electrons, and inert gas itself xenon, then 4f14 and 5d10 and 6s2 and 6b1. We can say the boron having the outermost electron in the 2s2 and 2p1. Aluminium outermost electrons 3s2 and 3p1. So therefore aluminium is the in third group. In case of the fourth group of boron family, the gallium. So gallium having the electronic configuration, the argon electronic configuration, then 3d10. So this we get the 3d10, and then outermost are the 4s and 4p1. In case of the indium, that is the inert gas configuration of that is krypton, and then 4d10 and 5s2 and 5p1. So indium itself present in the fifth period, and fifth period are where the electronic configuration itself clearly indicates that all of these boron family members having the three electrons. So whatever these particular three electrons, we see the 4s2, 4p1, 3s2, 3p1, 2s2, 2p1. So here we can say the chemical theory of bonding that clearly indicates that bonding will be, bonding is there, but there may be the sp2 type of hybridization, because when s electron, in case of the s, two electrons are there, so 2p1 electron. So what happened during the sp2 hybridization, for example in case of the boron, so 2s1 and 2px1 and 2py1. So therefore sp2 type of hybridization occurs generally in this particular, because of the, in case of the outermost electrons are the three electrons. Now the oxidation, after the oxidation state, this clearly indicates we have to come some other important the compounds of the boron, and this is showing the boron compound showing most important relevance with the different boron and covalent bonds, and they form a very complicated structure. Because what happened in case of the boron, we have earlier discussed that electron deficient. So why electron deficient in case of the boron? Because boron having only three electrons, so three electron combined with the three electron of three other hydrogen atoms, so therefore they form the covalent compounds. And but in boron the octet is not completed, so therefore these become a very complex, they can form a different complex formation, whatever the, in case of the multiple of that. But so in case of the BH3, whatever boron, so that can be dimer or whatever, there may be the other polymers may be also. So now one more thing is there, and that is the because of inert pair effect in these bonding is there. So what happened, what is the inert pair effect, and reluctance of NS2 whatever the in outermost electrons, the two electrons in s atomic orbitals to take part in the bonding. So due to that poor shielding effect of intervening d and f orbital on moving down, the group is known as the inert pair effect. What happened in this particular inert pair effect, there is the because of the poor shielding effect. Why? Because the electrons, and so therefore in this moving down we have to see the inert pair effect, that is because of that these are the special compound. Now we have to come whatever the relevance inform relevance knowledge. An atom differs from an ion in which of the following? This is one of the we have to see that so the correct answer here, very well known example, whatever if any of the atom differ from its ion, for example aluminium. In case of the aluminium, which among the following, so whether there is the difference in mass number, if in case of the aluminium 27, so aluminium 27 the mass number is 27, and number of protons are 13 and number of neutrons are the 14. What happened, the mass number itself is the number of proton and n number of neutron. So therefore the mass number of aluminium itself is 27. So that is atom having the 27, but what about the ion of aluminium plus 3? Similarly, in case of the boron, gallium, so gallium itself the an atom, and gallium plus 3 is the ion. So what happened in this particular case, the total number of proton and neutron, proton and neutron, that is the so total are the 27. So therefore in ion aluminium plus 3, that is also the 27. So there is a what we have to see, if aluminium plus 3, so is there a difference in, so that is the correct answer itself is and in case of the atomic number, what about the atomic number? Here the atomic numbers are the number of protons and number of electrons. So here then the neutrons, whatever the answer is, the number of protons. Here we can say if differs from its ion in which among the following, mass number, the atomic number, the neutrons, so whatever the differs from its ion, that is whatever we can say the number of proton. Now another one, the metallic character of this one is less than that of the alkaline earth metal. Here we can compare, this is the question regarding also the comparison between the alkaline earth metal. So out of these, which one having the metallic character less and more, and others have the more? So in this particular case, there are the examples. Suppose we have the alkali metals, then the magnesium, then the hydrogen. So in the this is, there is the correct answer is the A. So element of the boron family are less electropositive than the alkaline earth metals due to their smaller size, because that one is the also one of the factor, due to their smaller size and higher ionization enthalpies. On moving down the group, the electropositive character first increases from boron to aluminium. So therefore, and the aluminium plus 3 is there, then the electropositive from gallium to thallium decreases. This one, so here whatever we can say, that is because of the p and f orbitals. So in this particular case, from boron itself, then we have to downward aluminium. So aluminium, this is increased, then later on the ionic enthalpies are decreased. So therefore we can say due to the presence of the d and f orbital, because when we have to see the in case of the gallium, earlier we have discussed about the electronic configuration. So here aluminium 3s2 3p1, whereas in case of the gallium, then d electrons are there, d atomic orbitals 3d, then in case of the indium 4d, and whereas in case of the thallium 5d. So therefore d electrons and f electrons, those are responsible, and so therefore the correct answer in this case itself is the whatever we can say. So therefore then decrease from gallium to thallium due to the presence of d and f atomic orbitals, so which causes poor shielding. So because of the poor shielding, whatever the electropositive nature is the decreases, whereas in case of the aluminium, that is more, but that is poor is. Now the question is there, which of the following element exhibit plus 3 oxidation state only? Now in this particular case, The correct answer is the aluminium. Why? Aluminium, gallium, thallium, boron, and aluminium exhibit oxidation state of plus 3 only. While in case of the gallium, the indium, the thallium, okay, exhibit oxidation state of both plus 1 as well as plus 3. As we move down the group, the tendency to exhibit plus 3 oxidation state is decreases. So why that is decreases? Here also the inert pair effect. So that inert pair effect is the S atom electron. So whatever, as well as here D and F orbits are also there. So here you can say from down the group, the tendency of exhibit plus 3 oxidation state decreases. So therefore, in those particular elements, whatever we have already discussed, that these are however reactive metals. So in this particular case, the plus 3 oxidation state is also decreased. So complete removal of these 3 electrons from elements is not possible, because there is also the inert pair effect, whatever we have already discussed regarding the inert pair effect. So because of that, here plus 1 oxidation is also activated. So in case of the plus 1, what happened? The 2p, the last electron can be removed. So we have to see the electronic configuration of these. So here we can say the 4p1 electron and 5p1 electron and 6p1 electron, those are in gallium, indium, and thallium. So therefore, in those these 3 cases, plus 1 oxidation state as well as plus 3, both are there. But regarding the plus 3, due to inert pair effect, they exhibit the plus 1 oxidation state. So the also along with the plus 3, also they exhibit the plus 1. So therefore, from the following element, exhibit plus 3 oxidation state only. So this is the correct answer itself, is the whatever the D, and that is the aluminium in those particular variable oxidation state in gallium, thallium, and indium. Here also the because of the inert pair effect. Now the next question, that is related with the ionization enthalpy. In this particular case of the ionization enthalpy, which down the group of in the family. So here the current is irregular, and the explanation on moving down the group, ionization enthalpy decreases from boron to aluminium. But the next element, gallium, here the question is there. So therefore, gallium and metal is most important in advanced technology. However, aluminium is also used in different technologies. Whatever regarding the aluminium case, the lightweight material is prepared. So in those technology where lightweight material is required, so there is the mixing of aluminium itself. In case of the gallium, has the slightly higher oxidation ionization in enthalpies than aluminium due to over shielding of inter. Here also the d electron itself, and their shielding is poor. It again increase in indium and then decrease the last element of the thallium. Now one more question: which of the following is the correct order for stability of plus 1 oxidation? As we have earlier discussed, that oxidation state, that is correspond the inert pair effect as well as outermost electrons, and one more thing, and that is the d electrons and the f electrons. So whatever we can say that particular gallium, indium, thallium. So from the following, which is the correct order for the stability of plus 1 oxidation? What happened in case of the plus 1 oxidation state? That is the removal of one electron. whereas plus 3, and that is removal of 3 electrons. So what we have, this is regarding the gallium, indium and thallium. So the plus 1 oxidation state, when we have to see the electronic configuration, here the electronic configuration in the gallium, okay, indium and thallium. Here because of the inert pair effect and shielding of electrons, so therefore due to inert pair effect, only one electron is removed. So plus 1 oxidation state, whatever variable oxidation state in different family member of boron. So in this case, the gallium and indium and then thallium. In thallium case, the inert pair effect of S is there. So therefore, here plus 1 oxidation state is more exhibited. So last one, thallium, can showing the plus 1 oxidation state. Okay, now we have to see in this particular case the order, the correct order of increased stability. Whatever the plus 1 oxidation state is increased, and that is the gallium, indium and thallium. So why in case of the thallium plus 1 oxidation state is there? It's come however, in although though they have the compounds of gallium and indium also exhibited the plus 1 oxidation state, but the question is there the stability. So thallium compounds are more stable. For example, whatever we have to see the chlorine. So for example, if suppose BCl, the boron and then chlorine, the gallium GaCl3, then in case of the indium chloride InCl3. So and then we have to see thallium chloride. So in case of the thallium chloride, DlCl3. So DlCl3 compound having the plus 3. In case of the thallium chloride, that is the oxidation state is the plus 3. So therefore, the thallium exhibits plus 3 oxidation state. But because of the distance from the nucleus, so that outermost electron, and here more thing is the d electrons as well as f electrons. So because of the inert pair effect, they have come towards. So therefore, only one electron itself is removed. So in case of the thallium chloride, the DlCl will be there. That is the plus 1 oxidation state of thallium compound. Now the next question, what is there is the carbon, that carbon, all of you know about the carbon family and carbon itself, that is the atomic number 6. So carbide, what is the question is the aluminium carbide. Here we can say the carbon combined with the aluminium, the question is there. So all of you are well known that carbon and aluminium, so here we can say the group number 14 in case of the carbon, group number 13, that is of the aluminium. So 4 mole of aluminium atom combined with 3 moles of carbon atom on heating, okay, in order to form the aluminium carbide. So aluminium carbide is ionic in nature, and it also forms methane with water. That is the question. Its chemical formula is the AlC3. So that is the correct chemical formula of aluminium carbide is aluminium C3, where it is not ALC, not ALC2, and so this A, last one is whatever, only A, C3. So that is not the correct formula. So therefore, ALC3. So AC3 is also not there. Therefore, AlC3 is the correct chemical formula of aluminium carbide. Now, one more thing, whatever we have discussed, the inert pair effect. In case of the inert pair effect, this is the valence shell electrode to take part in the bonding, this one. So, whatever the part of bonding up from the outer shell electrode. So, down the group, we have already discussed the oxidation state of whatever the plus 3 and plus 1. So, in a family, in this particular group, the inert pair effect itself is increases. Why this increases? That we have already discussed. We have to see the electronic configuration. So, now we can say that when addition of electrons, that particular and intervening the d electrons and f electrons down the group, it increases. Below elements of the group exhibited. So because of that, plus 3 plus 1 oxidation state is exhibited by the thallium. Inert pair effect is the reluctance of a selection of valence shell to take part in the bonding. It occurs due to poor shielding of NS2 electron by intervening d electrons and f electron down the group, so it increases. The below elements of the group exhibit, because of that, lower oxidation state. So that's why thallium is exhibited in plus 1 as well as plus 3, but more is the plus 1. So that is because of the inert pair effect. So whatever that S electrons are toward the nucleus, so those are not allowed for the participation in the compound. So therefore, thallium Cl is present instead more than the Cl Cl3. Now, the another question. So whatever here, the boron reacts with nitrogen. What will be the compound here? Boron and nitrogen, whatever we can say, the boron in the 13, no, group number 13, and then 14 is the carbon, and then the nitrogen. So nitrogen itself is the 15 number, group 15 member. Boron reacts with group 13 to group 15. So what happened in this particular case? So which of the compound will be formed? The question is there that we have to see if nitrogen is there and boron is there. So combining with nitrogen, the nitrides are the form. So boron nitride is the correct answer. On heating, 2 moles of boron and boron atom combined with 1 mole of nitrogen molecule in order to form 2 moles of boron nitride. Therefore, aluminium also, when reacted with nitrogen, forms the aluminium nitride in the same way. Now, one more question, and what forms when boron combined with the caustic soda? Here the question, the caustic soda. Caustic soda itself is well-known compound, and that is the sodium, whatever caustic, potash caustic soda, sodium hydroxide. So here the correct answer, formation of the sodium borate, which is the stable compound. All of you are well known about the sodium borate, what will be the structure, that is also known. So here the correct answer, whatever out of these 4, the formation of oxygen, the formation of washing soda, that is sodium bicarbonate. Then we have the boron sodium carbonate, boron nitride, then the sodium borate. So 2 moles of boron atom fuse with 6 moles of sodium hydroxide in order to form 2 moles of sodium borate, that is the sodium borate, and 3 moles of hydrogen molecule. Sodium hydroxide is also known as the caustic soda, whatever the caustic soda, and here we have the sodium hydroxide. Now, the complex formation is more likely to be possible. Here, the complex formation in the boron family is greater than the S block elements due to their smaller size and greater charge. One thing is there, the charge is also here. We can say that they can form the complexes more likely than the alkali metal and as well as alkaline earth metal. So in a similar group, alkaline earth metal and alkali metal. So those are the, so here the correct answer is the boron family. Complex formation in boron family is more as compared to the alkali metal and alkaline earth metal. So all of you know about the alkali metal and alkaline earth metal, where the ionization potential is concerned with the formation of cation. So it's very easy in case of the alkali metals. So alkali metal form the metal plus charge, whereas alkaline earth metal forms the plus 2 charge. So the complex formation of the boron family is greater than the 5s block element due to their smaller size, and charges are also greater charge, so they can form the complex because of that, and more likely alkali metals are. Now this is well known, whatever we can see the electronic configuration, this one how the electronic configuration occurs in. So that's all about what we have already discussed, the case, the boron, aluminium, gallium and indium and thallium. So here we can say this one, the periodic table, here the S block. So here we can see the periodic table where B block elements, and here the family itself is the B boron family, that's aluminium, gallium and indium, that is shown in the green block area, and all these are the block. So here most important relevant itself is the incomplete octet. One thing is there, and another is the inert pair effect. So because of the inert pair effect, they have tendency to give the plus one oxidation. So those are the important, as well as one of the family member, aluminium. So aluminium itself is third most element. Our aluminium is also the metal that is present on the earth. So this is in case of the gallium and indium, because of these particular things, they have they can use in the formation of semiconductors. So those are advanced materials, gallium and indium. But now we can say that boron family, here the all those, we can say boron family exhibited with, from top to bottom, boron, then aluminium, then the gallium, then the indium, and lastly thallium. So thallium related compounds are less, and however thallium also is the toxic. Aluminium, which is the metal and which is most abundant, third in number on the earth. So that's about. Anyone have the any difficulty, any information relevance, any knowledge sharing, then he or she can ask me any of the query questions regarding this present video lecture. So all you are welcome to visit Suresh Gyanvihar University, and Suresh Gyanvihar University that is having the world best infrastructure as well as world's best human resources. So all the best. You can all to visit the Suresh Gyanvihar University. Okay, all the best.